Hi, if you're using the Zoho Sales IQ and everything is in place, you have the code, you have the chat popping up, but now you're eager and excited to start to use the answer bot, but you don't know how to set up, this video is for you. My name is Alex Vaz with Cornerstone Solutions. I'm going to be showing you here how to activate, enable the answer bot to your sales IQ. As you're in your sales IQ, that's the first interface. Go to the top right here, the gear settings. Under here, go under bot, you have answer bot. You have Zoho bot and answer bot. Zoho bot is with a script. It's a little bit different how it works from the answer bot. It uses AI. We can take a look on that in another video. But today we're just focused on the answer bot. Just click answer bot. As you get in for the first time, it's going to be disabled. Let's enable. Now it's enabled. Let's click on the, you can click any location here. You need to set up your profile. You can give the name, like I just put here Cornerstone Solutions, but you can give a name to the robot here, however it works for you. You're going to connect to a department. If you haven't created yet, given the name, I just put the general name here, Cornerstone Solutions. You have the resource, and that's where I'm going to be showing you how to populate that. You can keep them all on, articles, FAQ, and small talk. I'm going to explain how they work. It's going to be in another interface. Response. You can change how it reacts to the simple response here. If the answer is not found, related source suggestion, you can if you can choose what to show as a button after, you know, as you move forward with that. The same with the behavior. you can define how it works in business hours, non-business hours. The criteria you can add as well if you want to change the criteria. You can active those options, proactive interaction, idle chat handling. The response interval is like how long it takes from one to another as it comes automatically. And to hand off to an operator, you can go and activate that based on your needs on your company. Fallbacks, the same, you have the options here, the simple answers and buttons that are come after the answer. You need to see how it works for your company, and you can define, change, update those texts. But what are we going to be looking more today is to really see how to add the information in the system, so you can provide like a specific data. Right now I have added already, let's say we put here Zoho CRM and we click, it gives you, you notice here that it gives like two options here. It gives these text that comes almost someone typed and gives this one here as an article. And that's the difference where I'm gonna show you. Basically this one here is the FAQ. And the other one is the article. If you come over here, source, and if we turn off article, and we save, and we type again, Zoho CRM, it only gives the FAQ. This, I would recommend as you're adding this information, I'm gonna show you how to add, to think how it works the best for you. We normally here at our company, we prefer adding as a content, even though it's a long content in the box. But some people might prefer adding an article, even if the article has more information, including like photos and more details, might be better to add as an article. Let's keep both on for now. And I'm going to show you how to add them. The small talk, it's also like a small communication, which I'm going to show you how this interaction works. Let's go to this other tab here. Let's go back, close here. As you're in this main interface, you go to resource. Let's go first to the FAQs. I have only one here. This is my demo. And you can go and add a new one. You can import if you have like Excel with the information. If you have everything structured in another way, you can import the data to here. But let's compose one. Basically here, I'm going to grab the text here. Let's put to what's Zoho one. And the response, I'm going to add as a small blurb here as this option. And you can go and if you want kind of give some emphasis and bold, you can go and update that. After you add the information, you need to select the department. That's what I mentioned. We're going to go back and I'm going to show you how the department works. But let's say we select Cornerstone Solutions, the category. Right now, I only have Zoho CRM in general. I'm going to click Manage. We're going to click Add and put Zoho 1. And you check the little thing here. It has been added. We can close it. Now we go to Category. You have Zoho 1 here. Okay. Once everything is set up, you can also associate an article. In this case, we don't have yet. But let's go and click publish. Now let's go to settings here. Let's do a little refresh. And let's type Zoho 1. It posts the article here because it has information related, but here's the blurb that I just added. Okay, let's go back now to the source. Let's click article. The same way you can go and add importing or composing. Let's click compose. And the name of the article we're going to use. What's Zoho 1? Then it goes to the interface to edit the article. This one here, you will have more information. Let's add. And you see it came already with bold. If you have, if you want to add more, like a format, add more formatting to the structure to the article, you can use that. You can insert. And you can insert image. You can really, it's pretty much as work in any text editor. Okay. The same here at this version. If you have, let's close this one here. Let's select the department, Cornerstone. It's still in the draft version. It doesn't have any update yet. And the category, the same here. It's different from the FAQ. You need to add here again. Let's go and add one. Check here, it closed. And now we have so one. Let's click publish. You see it's related to Zoho 1. Let's go back to here. Let's do a little refresh. Let's put the Zoho 1. You have now it came like the article, the little FAQ that I added there. But you see it becomes sometimes redundant here. If it's the same information, you can pick to use one of them or you can add it just one. Or if you do that, you can also add here for more information, be more specific for the article. Okay. And let's go back to here. We have resource, small talk. It already comes with a default package. You can always add yours, you know, how you want to communicate. It's basically when you say hi, you give like a feedback for a small conversation. And you have different type of from courtesy, personal inquiries, support, and sign off. You can go through this one here. It's a default, as I mentioned, but you can always add one that would be more personalized to your organization. Okay, let's close here. It's another great way to keep the conversation on the chat box. That's the overall. It's kind of straightforward how to add it. Yeah, I mentioned about the department. I'm just going to close here to make sure when you are creating, I would make sure as you, if you haven't done yet, to go through all the steps, all the settings here, and make sure you add your department here. You can add more than one department, and the conversation it's going to be associated with the department. It might be helpful as you use the customer service to help your clients. Okay, that's the overall structure of this is IQ with the answer bot. If you have any other questions, if you'd like to learn more about the sales IQ, please contact us. We would love to hear from you. Thank you.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.